Hi guys! I am back from a 3-week-ish hiatus. I was over in Europe. I went to London, Paris, and Greece. And it was amazing, but I came home because it's Pumpkin Palooza. I mean, that's the main reason, let's be honest. It's Pumpkin Palooza, Trader Joe's, so I need to go and like, I couldn't get everything pumpkin because there's so much this year, it's wild. So I got a select handful of things. But it's funny because while I was grocery shopping, I started in like the produce and the healthy stuff. And as I'm there, like I see my cart's like almost like the whole bottom is full. And I'm like, oh dear, we have not even got to the pumpkin stuff. So anyways, I got all the pumpkin stuff. Well, not all of it, but a lot of it. So I'm gonna go through this. There's a lot of things I'm gonna sample today. So let's jump in. First of all, I got this because it's yellow, which is one of my favorite colors. And how cute is it? Don't really need an explanation for that. I have several of them. I have a white one, all different kinds. So here's some just regular things I got. I wanted to try, this is a horrible month, I wanted to try and do Whole30 to like kind of reset myself, but I was like, this is the worst month to do it, because like everything pumpkin's coming out and you cannot do Whole30 when pumpkin spice is in town. So I kind of just got stuff that I enjoy eating and I'm still gonna do my best to like eat like a bit cleaner. And this is one of the ways I'm gonna do it, with the cassava and coconut tortilla chips. These things are delicious. They're crunchy, they're like a thick siete chip, and I love them. I've sampled them in the past, so I can provide a link to my website where you can just type in the chip and it'll show me sampling it, so save you guys some time on that. No one needs me to sample kale, because everyone knows what kale tastes like, but I do like the organic Tuscan kale. It's my favorite. I truly wish Trader Joe's carried like the big leaves and then I could do it myself because that just makes me happy. But here we are. For breakfast or like a sandwich midday lunch, I got the gluten-free English muffins. Even if you're not gluten-free, these taste incredible. So good. And they're 150 calories each. They come pre-sliced. Just toast them. You have to toast them or else they're cardboard. But just toast them and then put whatever kind of meats and cheeses you want on it. These things are delish. Love them. Oh, as part of my sweet tooth at night, instead of eating cookies, which I had a very bad, I guess I still have that habit, I picked up some raspberries. I'm just gonna eat one right now because they look so good. And these are the organic ones. So here we go. One raspberry for me. But there's a lot in here. So, raspberry is one of my favorite fruits. Absolutely love them. I also picked up a mixed Melody cherry tomatoes. I feel like you guys want some pumpkin spice stuff. Hold on, let me get the stuff out of the freezer. Okay, let's get you the stuff you want. This is the content. This is the content you're here for. Pumpkin spice. I was boring you with all the produce. I need a spoon to try this. Okay, produce, let's try spoon. Okay, spoon. I don't know where my little gold spoons are. Okay, we're gonna do a big spoon. I've had this every year. I allow myself to buy one of them. This is the pumpkin ice cream, super premium, and I don't know if I'm the only one, but I find that this has gotten a bit larger, or I'm used to the ube ice cream, but I feel like there's more in here. And also, I couldn't find it, and then I had to use the restroom at Trader Joe's, and on my way to the restroom, in the corner was a freezer, a small freezer, and it was full of just the pumpkin ice cream, so it was hiding. So make sure if you can't find it at your local Trader Joe's, you ask, because they could be hiding it. So here it is. It's this like beautiful pumpkin spice color. This is actually gonna be the first pumpkin spice bite of 2021. Oh, here we go. It's soft, creamy. Mmm. It really like tastes like pumpkin pie filling. So if you like that, combine it with the texture of ice cream. You're gonna get cinnamon, nutmeg. It's creamy, it's delicious. I think that if you like pumpkin spice, you will absolutely love this ice cream. I'm just gonna take a small bite for the road. I'm just gonna put this back in the freezer with my lineup of Trader Joe's ice creams where they live. Before I do that, we have to try the Hold the Cone. These, obviously everyone loves the Hold the Cone. I have a gluten allergy. It's not going to kill me, but I will not be eating the cone. I will just be eating the top part off the Hold the Cone. Oh, how cute are they? They come in this little serving tray, which some people get upset with because it's plastic, which I hear you. I just, the dogs think I'm getting a treat out for them. Oh, that's coming. Here they are. Really cute. So it's like a pumpkin spice, and then it has like a frosted flavor on the top. So let's get a bite of this going. It's kind of making me like sweat a little bit because I think the sugar is so good, but it tastes just like the ice cream, but with like a vanilla coating on it, which is very delicious. So good, so good. I'm just gonna finish off the top because I don't want to waste it. Okay, yummy. Yummy, yummy. My friends that eat gluten will be very happy with me when I give them the Hold the Cone ice cream. All right, what do we have next? One more pumpkin item. This bread is so good. This is the gluten-free pumpkin bread. Again, even if you're not gluten-free, this is incredible. They also have a bread mix, which I love, and I add like my favorite protein powder to it, and it makes it like a nice, dense, proteiny bread. So it's good for in the morning, it'll keep you full, but this gluten-free pumpkin bread is so, so, so good. Again, toast it. If you want to double down when they come out with the pumpkin cream cheese, pumpkin spice cream cheese, it's fa-la-la-la-la. I was thinking like fa-la-lu-ya, but like it just didn't come out of my mouth right. Like, and then to balance it all off, arugula, pumpkin spice arugula. Just kidding, it's regular, it's regular. But imagine, can you imagine? Maybe it'll come out with like a pumpkin spice dressing. It'd be like a vinaigrette, but that might be too much, but it would be fun. I also picked up some chips. I had a very concerning moment today at Trader Joe's, so while I was gone, my favorite sweet potato chips seem to have disappeared, and I'm not happy about it. So I picked up these vegetable root chips, which ironically, when I was in Mykonos in Greece, we went into this grocery store, which I kid you not, it was like the Trader Joe's of Greece, and I was obsessed. Like, I was walking around, I loved everything about it. It was like just outside of Mykonos, like we walked there from Mykonos, and I was just like, where am I? I want to film this. Maybe I should go back and film it. But anyways, I was hungry and I wanted chips, and so I bought a bag of these chips. So now this reminds me of Mykonos, the Mykonos Trader Joe's. It was like so cute. I couldn't get over it. Ooh, these are fun and brand new. Caramel sea salt baking chips. Never heard of these before, so we're going to have to try them. We are going to have to try them. What should they look like? As you'd expect, they're like a little caramely color. They look like a chip. I'm kind of far back so you can't see these, but I'll zoom in on it when I put this on IGTV. The reason I went or like backed up in my head was they kind of have a bit of like a coffee flavor. So it's more of like a burnt caramel flavor. And I was expecting more of a like, when you put caramel into ice cream, it's like a caramel swirl. That's interesting. It is good, and perhaps if you put this into like a vanilla ice cream, it would taste more like a vanilla swirl. But okay, kind of like the bag's kind of hard to read, so make sure if you're interested in getting these, which I think you should, like in a cookie, I think these would be phenomenal. Wow, and the sea salt really kicks you at the end. Yeah, those are good. But make sure you just like look for the shiny bag. It's a bit hard to read, but you can find it if you look hard enough. For the dogs, I got them pumpkin maple bagel. Where are the words? Words. Bonjour. Pumpkin maple bacon flavored stuffies. Dog treats. Do you guys want a treat? Who wants a treat? Here they come. Okay. We'll give Boo a treat first. Come here, Boo. Sit. Insert Boo. Let me see. Is this hard for you to eat? He wants me to set him down. Okay. And then up next is Pot Pie. Where are you? Come here. Pot Pie wants some air time. Here you go. You ready? She's the pickier one. Oh, is this not for you? Pot Pie. Pot Pie turned it down. She's so picky. She's so picky. She likes certain things. Maybe if I set her down. You want it now? Okay. Well, what she said is she gets camera shy and now she wants it. So she took it, she's run off with it. But if she declined it, it wouldn't be the first time. The groomers always give them treats and she's like, get that away from me. I only eat from Trader Joe's. Back to the pumpkin stuff that we can eat. Gluten-free pumpkin bread muffin baking mix. This is what I was telling you about that I love, and I add protein powder to it, and it makes it delicious. It's perfect. So now that it's pumpkin season, it just popped in my head. I want to make like little balls that I can take when I go on bike rides and then eat them when I get hungry. Fun. Fun, fun, fun. This isn't pumpkin shaving cream, but it is orange. And I'm so excited because I dropped this in the shower when I had just bought a fresh one, and it broke the entire top off. And so like I didn't want to waste it. So then it's been like this awkward thing in my shower that I've like been trying to manage and work with. And anyways, I'm just happy it's done with, because now I can set something like this instead of on its side and awkward. But this is the best shave cream if you've never used it. And it's cruelty free. Let's go with some produce. We'll do this quickly. I got a red bell pepper. I bought a lemon. I actually bought two lemons. I also picked up two avocados, which surprisingly great selection. One's ripe for this week. This one will be ready in a day or two. I like it when that's the case. I also picked up a red onion. All of these things are for my healthy eating habits. And this just accidentally fell in my cart. This is the double chocolate hot cocoa stirring spoon. This is just the content you want when you're watching stuff and you just see someone twirl something and then it melts. We're gonna do one of those for you. A sipping chocolate, and it comes with little marshmallows in it, so I'm excited to try it. Very excited. I also picked up a pumpkin bell pepper. Just kidding, this is just regular bell pepper, but it's orange. But it's orange. My jokes are so good today. Pumpkin overnight face mask. Here we go. We're gonna put a little bit on my hands, but there is a pun on the back. So it says, hello, gorgeous. Gourd, like a gourd. And just, yeah, you guys get it. Okay. So this is, I'm sure, like a spinoff of the regular one that they have that everyone seems to love. I actually have the original, starts with an L, Laneige. I can't think of the name, but it's L-A-N something something something. Fill in the blanks. But I use their face, their overnight face moisture thing, and I actually used it last night. So, like, the consistency feels the same. It doesn't smell like pumpkin spice, by the way. It just has pumpkin fruit extract in it. Oh my god, I guess pumpkin is a fruit because it has seeds. Never thought about that. Oh wow. Did you know pumpkin was a fruit? Like, if someone was like, is pumpkin a fruit, would you guess that's right? It actually smells like really, really nice. And it has plant-derived squalene in it. I believe that's good for like anti-aging. Dry skin, avoid the eye area. So we're gonna see how this goes, see if my hand looks any better at the end of this segment. Okay, what haven't I shown you in here? I picked up the pumpkin Alfredo sauce. We have to try this. New spoon. Also going to grab, okay. Obviously you don't eat this the way I'm eating it, but I think if you can taste something and it's in its warm phase, then when it's heated, it's better. So this is made in Italy, the squash and cheese forward. I bet this is gonna be good. Because if you think of pumpkin as just a squash, when you puree it into Alfredo sauce, it probably gives it a very delicious texture. So here it is. It smells like a tomato-y Alfredo sauce, which is interesting. Like, you don't smell pumpkin. So I'm excited, let's see. Honestly, if I did a blind taste testing of this, I wouldn't guess pumpkin, which I think is fun because it could be two over the top, but the first ingredient's pumpkin. So I think what the pumpkin does is just give it like a creamier, thicker texture. Absolutely delicious. I'm really excited to put this on a pasta. Yummy. I didn't have any pasta or pizza for the last 3 weeks, so I am ready to have some pasta. And I'm also ready to taste the vanilla bean paste on the other end of that spectrum. This, everyone seemed to be really excited about the Instagram post about this being here. So this is a paste. I'm wondering what you do with it. It has a crunchy texture and flavor. Oh dear. How are we gonna get into this? Oh dear. Ah, okay, I like had to poke my nail into it. New spoon to try that. Wow, a lot of spoons today. Keep going to the wrong drawer because I just moved in and I don't know where I'm at. Okay. Another small spoon, we're back. I don't know if the small spoon's gonna cut it. Okay, good, it pours. Okay, here we go. You can see there's like these little vanilla bean bits in it, which is delicious. Oh, yummy. That you could just eat with a spoon. With a spoon, but like I don't think you're supposed to do that at all because it's an extract, which means it has alcohol in it. Yummy. Yummy. I would put this on, I would add this to cookies. I'd be tempted to do a little drizzle on like some ice cream, or you could add this to your latte. That'd be delicious. Pumpkin spice vanilla bean latte. I approve of that. Or you could just do a vanilla bean latte. This is delicious. Highly, highly recommend it. I understand what all the hype's about. You guys do too, because you're the ones that liked it. Okay, Green Goddess Seasoning Blend. This I saw come out while I was gone, and I love the Green Goddess products in general, so just gotta get through the security on this. Nope, not today. I also haven't had my nails done in like a month, so they're like so long. When I try and take my contacts out at night, it's nearly impossible. Nearly. I'm just like, does anyone have a spare hand? Okay. Green Goddess seasoning. It has dried minced onion, salt, granulated garlic, ground black pepper, dried chives, dried green onions, spinach powder, lemon powder. My mouth's watering thinking about this. Wow. I'm gonna put some right here in my clean hands and give it a taste. Oh gosh, that's good. That is so good. I want to put this on chicken breast. This is incredible. Have you guys tried this? Everything in it is something that I would really like. Wow. Okay. Big fan. One more bit. That was a lemon bit. So good. And then I also picked up 3 bags of the Amped Up almonds. These are just like, you guys know I eat those every day. Those are my favorite everyday chocolate almonds because they have protein. They're not too sweet. You can eat them and you feel great. All right. We've gone through 2 bags. This one's fully empty. I just don't have a lot of counter space to work with at this moment. So we're gonna jump into this one, which I got some green onions. Just love to cook with those, put those in everything. Some shredded cabbage, because I will be revisiting my Subaru salad, which I posted to IGTV. I posted it to the Reels, and it's so good. Try making it. It's a game changer. Healthy eating, filling, everything you'd want. Parsley. Cilantro, I did want chives, but they were out of chives, unfortunately, which is always a bummer. Let's try this. This is a new cheese. Well, or it could be coming back, but I don't recall it from the past. It's the beehive cheese rubbed with Hatch chili. And I wasn't gonna buy more cheese this week, but they had me at chili. So I'm gonna just do this. Don't be worried, I've used this knife before. This is a great knife. Woo, by Meissen. Okay, yummy. Just trying to do this delicately with my nails that are too long. All right, here we go, a little small piece just broke off. We're just gonna cut the top off like so. Okay, break it off. Here it is, beehive cheese with honey. Rub with Hatch chili. I love chilies, anything. And the back looks like that's what's rubbed with chili. Mmm, wow. Okay, if you like spice and the flavor of Hatch chili, that's incredible. That is so good. It does say award winning on the front, and I understand that. If you guys see this and you're into spice and cream, like the cheese texture is so good. I don't want to say it tastes like the white part of the cheese kind of tastes like a cheddar, like a white cheddar, but then the bits within it are just like full of flavor, and there's a bit of salt to it with the chili pepper flavor. I'm very, very happy about this. Not mad at all that I bought it. I'm gonna go ahead and move the knife over here just so I don't hurt myself. Pick up those flowers. Those are the gerberas, I think that's how you say it. They're like the most low maintenance flower to buy. You don't have to do any pruning when you buy them, and I think they're $4.99. I got 3 different bundles. Berry Fresh blackberries. Love these as well. I'm gonna have one. This again will be added to my sweet tooth at the end of the night. These are totally delicious. Go with my raspberries. I like berries. As a kid, we would pick these in Pennsylvania. Mm-hmm. Okay. Just gonna stack things. I picked up some cucumbers because, as I said, I'm gonna make the Subaru salad. These go in it. Oh dear. at this point, I'm doing a juggling game. Some organic creamy mushrooms. I'm gonna do those as like, maybe I'll add those when I make the pumpkin Alfredo sauce pasta. I'll add the creamy mushrooms to it. Ooh, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm so excited. So excited. I picked up some Go Macro bars. This is the seasonal flavor, which is Pure Promise maple sea salt. I took a box of these with me to Europe because I can't eat a lot of gluten, and as you know, there's a lot of croissants and things. And so I would have a Go Macro bar in the morning instead. Let's give this a try. Okay, it's a little tougher. This has like a power bar consistency. I don't know if they're all like this or just this bar in particular. Let's see. Mmm. This one's really chewy. Usually not like that. It tastes like it wants to be a maple waffle, but it has a different texture. It's not crunchy. Like the maple waffle magic spoon is incredible because it kind of feels like you're eating a crunchy waffle. This is good. I don't like how it's a bit harder to eat than the, I usually get the oatmeal chocolate chip ones, which are my fave, but that's okay. Ooh, more pumpkin stuff. Several more. Man down. It's okay. We'll move on. Pumpkin four cheese Greek style yogurt dip. A savory, creamy pumpkin dip with shredded Monterey Jack cheese, a bunch of cheese. Monterey Jack, sharp cheddar, cream cheese, and Parmesan cheese. We are gonna try this. I'm gonna be, I keep doing it every time. Okay. More spoons out. Planning ahead this time, because I know there's a couple more things to try that are pumpkin. Pumpkin four cheese Greek style dip, okay. I'm assuming you need a chip for this, but I'm just going straight with the spoon. This looks interesting to say the least. I bet it's gonna be similar to the Alfredo sauce. That is good. It has more of a pumpkin spice flavor than I expected. Let's see, there's a lot of ingredients, so I also think I still have the Go Macro bar flavor in my mouth, so I might have to revisit this. It's good, I just don't know what dip would replace this. It's good. I just find it a bit interesting. I'm not sure I love this, but it does tell me to heat it for 20 seconds, and perhaps that's why it's not as good to me, is because I'm eating it straight out of that instead of eating it with the way the directions intended to be, which I understand that because like gluten-free bread, you don't do gluten-free bread and cook it, it tastes like cardboard. So we'll give that one another shot once we heat it up. Pumpkin spice hummus. This is a new item. I've never seen them pumpkin spice hummus. I like that every year they're like, what else can be pumpkin spice? And I'm sure someone's like, hummus. And here we are. Okay. Here's the spoon, I couldn't find it. I was traveling and I saw this on the internet and I was like, I cannot wait to try this. This is the pumpkin spice hummus. I actually think it is spice. Yeah, pumpkin spice. So let's see if this actually has spice. It does have garbanzo beans, cane sugar, pumpkin puree, water, sunflower oil, pumpkin spice blend. So there's sugar, pumpkin powder, vanilla extract. This is gonna be interesting. And when would you eat this? I'm rethinking my palate right now. I'm trying to get it to a balance. Okay, so now pumpkin spice is a dessert. You could literally take a pie, put the pumpkin spice hummus in it, maybe bake it. That's delicious, and that should not be a dip because it is. You could literally just eat this with a spoon. What are the... Okay. So 2 tablespoons of 70 calories. So there's 8 servings, so 8 times 7. Okay. And then we've got 40, okay, carbs, how much sugar? Only 7 grams of sugar in 8 times 7, okay, got that. All right, well, it's up to you. If this is your dessert at night, I'm not gonna be mad about it. It tastes just like a dessert. I think it's really good. It's literally arguably better than the, what did we have first that was pumpkin spice? Oh, we had the ice cream. It tastes like a refrigerated ice cream, if that makes sense. That could sound a little gross. All right, what do we have next? We've got sweet and spicy I feel like I'm sweating right now. So much pumpkin stuff. Sweet and spicy, sweet and savory, lightly spiced pumpkin spread. And it comes in literally the cutest jar I've ever seen. So cute. Whoever designed this one, I don't even want to open it, but here we are. This is definitely going to go in gift bags. I already see it. Oh my gosh. And then even the cap is cute. Okay, we're going to try this. Oh my gosh. I might need a strong person. Okay. It actually worked. Usually that never works. Like, I see people do it, and then I try it, and then it just doesn't work. Okay, here we go. Again, the wrong drawer. Okay. We've run out of gold spoons. So I guess this would go on your cheese board. Pumpkin spice. Okay, here we go. It kind of has the consistency of like a chutney, so it's a bit thicker with chewy bits in it. I wouldn't say I taste like so much pumpkin as I taste like, interesting. So here's the ingredients. Pumpkin, cane sugar, fruit pectin, that's what's giving it the, fruit pectin, lemon juice, ground cinnamon. So I would say like, the pumpkin's mild, but you taste the lemon juice and the cinnamon, so it's like a surprising flavor. I think maybe if it was added to, like with cheese, it would be good. But as its own, like it's kind of funky because it's like a lemon cinnamony flavor, which I'm not entirely used to. All right, we're almost done here. This is new. Pomander Room Spritz. Okay, I'm going to spray it. Ooh, very, very fall-esque. It's got like cinnamon. That's what I smell, and clove. So this is nice. I'll put this in a bathroom. I don't know if I want my bedroom smelling like that. And then I also picked up some organic zucchini. Maybe I'll add that to the pasta. No, I'm not going to add that to the pasta. Maybe. And then jicama wraps. These are good for tortillas. You can, if you're making tacos, you can either use them raw or sometimes you can heat them up. It's really your choice. I like them either way. There's a phase where I would put them on like a griddle and get them hot, and then I'd stack two on top of each other. But if you don't want to do that much work, they're good cold too because they're a little bit crunchy. Choose your adventure. And then last but not least, I got oat milk for my lattes in the morning. So that's it. I was shocked it was only $169. I really thought it was going to be more, and I'm very satisfied with this haul. I really need to figure out my camera situation, but thank you for bearing with me. Let me know what your favorite item is in this haul, and then also let me know what new pumpkin item you want me to get next week. There are so many. Like, I can't keep track of all of them. There's just so many. And I'm sure there's going to be more. But you guys have a great week. I'll post this to IGTV tomorrow or Thursday, depending on when we can edit it. And then it'll go up on YouTube on Sunday. Sorry, backwards. It'll go up on IGTV. Did I say that? Sunday? And then on Instagram. Oh my God. Rewind. I'm sugar brain. Rewind. Hey guys. This will go up on IGTV Sunday and on YouTube tomorrow or Thursday. So thanks for bearing with me. I clearly need to eat something for lunch because it's late here and I haven't done that. But you guys have a great week. Thank you for being back and being here. And I'm excited to be back and try more things. So what am I going to eat next? See you guys later. Bye.